Meetings, meetings, and more meetings. Chances are your days and your weeks are full of meetings. But if you're a Google Calendar user, there are ways in which you can make meetings more manageable. So today I want to share with you five of my favorite tips for both managing your meetings, but also creating new meetings as well. So let's jump right in. My very first one has to do with taking a look at our settings within Google Calendar. Now, by default, your new events are usually set to 60 minutes. Your default duration is set for 60 minutes, but you don't have to keep it at that level. Google gives us a few different ways in which we can shorten our default duration. I'm surprised at how few people create a 15-minute meeting. I mean, think about it. Whatever you determine as your meeting, chances are you're going to fill up that entire time. So if you want to switch from 60 to 30, you can do so. And if you feel the necessity to go all the way up to 120 minutes, you can do so as well. But there's an additional option here that I want to point out, and that is Google's speedy meetings. If you check this checkbox, you will notice that our default duration options up here will change. Yes, we still start at 15 minutes, but instead of 30-minute meetings, they're 25-minute meetings. Instead of one-hour meetings, they are 50-minute meetings. And this is most valuable for the individuals in which you invite to your meetings. So for example, if I set 50 minutes as my default duration, I think I'm sending a very powerful message to those who I invite to my meetings. Is that, listen, I really want to get things wrapped up before the top of the hour. Give us ample time to prepare for that next meeting or to get on with our day. So don't be afraid to change your default duration, and if you like, to even turn on and give speedy meetings a try. Now, as we manage all of our meetings, let's stay here within the settings section of Google Calendar. And sometimes it can be difficult to remember where all the different places we need to go, all of the commitments that we have. Well, if you go into your individual calendar, you can actually send a daily agenda to yourself. Now, you have to do this at the individual calendar level, but if you go down to general notifications, you will see here, I can send myself a daily agenda. This can be a great way to give you a snapshot of your day. It will send it to you at 5 a.m. in your current time zone. For most of us, that's more than early enough. It will send us our daily agenda for that day. Now, if you turn this on for more than one calendar, it will not send you several emails. If I wanted to turn this on for some of the other calendars that I have here, it will summarize it all in this individual email. But this can be a great way to start your day. Many of us start our day with email anyhow. We can get a snapshot of our day. Let's take a look at what it looks like here within Gmail. So here is my agenda for today. It was sent to me at 5 a.m. I've got some of my tasks, which I have created as all day tasks. And then here I have my commitments as a part of the day. And the great thing is that this is also linkable, so I don't even have to open up my calendar. I can click on these individual items and go directly to those aspects, to that part of my calendar. So let's continue with email and how we can manage our meetings and even create new meetings directly from our email. Chances are, if you use Google Calendar, there's a very good chance that you are using Gmail as your primary email client. So let's open up this email, which I received a little earlier today. And in it, it's talking about a meeting, seeing if I can join them. This actually isn't a invitation, something I can accept and it will add automatically to my calendar. This is something that someone would really like me to attend, but they know that my time may already be taken up by other commitments. Let's say I do decide to join this particular meeting. Do I click on my Google Calendar and start, copying and pasting all this information? That seems like a bit of a waste of time. No, instead, what I can do is I can go up here to the More button and I can select Create Event. And what it's going to do is it's going to open up my calendar, and here it's brought in the subject line of that particular email, And it's also brought in all the contents of that email down below. Here I've got all the pertinent information, location information, date information, and now it's very easy for me to edit this particular event. I'm probably not gonna leave it at this. I'm gonna give it a proper name up here, and I'm gonna make sure my date and time is correct. But with just one click, I've got all of that valuable information from my email right here, and I can create that event automatically. So another way that we can make use of email and create new meetings directly from our email account. Now, this next one is a new extension, or at least it's new to me, that I think is absolutely fantastic. This may be one of my favorite extensions so far when it comes to Google Calendar. Often you have your calendar tab open, right? How often do you come back here to see where you are, where you're supposed to be, what's coming up next in your schedule? Well, there is a Google Chrome extension, and here you see it in the top right-hand corner. And it's very helpful even without clicking on it. In fact, if you can see, there's even a small 2H standing for 2 hours, and as I hover over it, it's actually telling me that my next appointment is happening in about 2 hours' time, and it even tells me what that appointment is. So I can be browsing on anything else. I can be in my Trello board, let's say, for example, and I can click on this extension. And look at this, I've got sort of a micro calendar. I've got a mini version of my calendar. Here I can see my agenda for the coming days. It gives you your next full week out ahead of you that you can see. This is all clickable, so I can click on any of these items and go directly to that calendar. I can even add events directly from this Chrome extension. So I think this is fantastic. No longer do I need to jump back to my Google Calendar tab within my browser. I can simply just use the Chrome extension. You can also edit to determine how many of your calendars you would like to appear here. Maybe you don't want all of your calendars to show up here, but this can be a great and simple way for you to see your agenda at a glance. You can interact with your calendar without actually going to the Google Calendar tab. Now, the last tip that I want to share with you today has to do with meeting agendas. Here we've got an example here in Trello. I like to remind people when they're creating events within Google Calendar that they have a full HTML description area down below. I know many of us will go in and actually type in the description, right? We'll type in the agenda here, and that's helpful for others who have been invited, other guests who are joining us on that meeting. But a lot of us want to take notes at the same time that we are in that meeting. So we want a bit more of a dynamic agenda as we are going through our day. So there's a couple of ways that we can make this more functional and a better use of our time and hopefully the time of others. One would be to add an attachment of that agenda. And here what I can do is I can go to my Google Drive, and here I've got a sample team meeting agenda. I can select it, and now everyone who gets invited to this meeting can have a direct link to this team meeting agenda. And if I change things in that agenda, I don't have to come here and reload this particular attachment. No, I can have it right there, and we can keep notes, we can add further information, and everyone has access to this particular meeting agenda. Now, what if you don't use Google Drive? Well, you could upload another document if you like, but chances are you might be using some other cloud service. So let's take a look at a Trello example. Let's say that you and your team are using something like Trello or Asana or some other online service to keep track of your meeting agenda. And here it is, and you want to take notes and add comments in this location. Well, almost everything has a unique link. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come down here and I'm going to find the link to this particular card. I'm going to go back to my meeting invite, and remember, we've got access to links. So I'm going to say, here's the meeting agenda, and maybe I can just remind people to click here. I'm going to highlight this line and I'm going to select link. And here I can just paste that link and say okay. And once again, now I've got direct access to a dynamic meeting agenda. After I send out this invitation, this could even be a recurring invitation. Now I've got direct access to this meeting agenda, which actually lives and breathes within Trello or some other service that you may be using. So don't forget that you have a full HTML editable description area right here where you can attach documents, you can format at bullet points or a numbered list, and add direct links to other services which you may be using. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope that you're getting the most out of your Google Calendar as you manage your meetings on a day-to-day basis. Did I miss something? Is there something that helps you as you use Google Calendar to manage all of your meetings? Or, of the five that I shared, which one was your favorite? I'd love to hear from you, so be sure to add a comment below. Thank you again for watching. Please subscribe right here to the Simpletivity YouTube channel. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.